Is there a downside to the DM method? I have recently been struggling with integration by parts and stumbled upon the DM method from BPRP. I wonder who that guy is. This seems so much easier, but it was never mentioned by my instructor. Is there some downside to using this method or reason to use IBP over DI? I will tell you this right away. Is there a downside to the DM method? The answer to this right here is a no. And the reason is because the DI method is really the same as IBP, the traditional integration by parts. This right here is just an easier way to organize your work in comparison to the traditional UDV format. So let me explain what I mean by that. Traditionally, for integration by parts, the formula says we have to integrate UDV and then we will get UV minus the integral of V du. So notice, we break down this integral into two parts. U is to be differentiated. That's how we can get du here. And then dv is going to be integrated, so we can end up with V. Okay, so let me demonstrate this right here real quick. And the example I have in mind is, let's integrate inverse tangent of x. So our goal is to break down this integral into two parts, u and dv. So let's go ahead and make our selection. And I will recommend you to put down the setup like this. U right here and dv right here. And remember, for u, once you put it here, you will have to differentiate it so you can get du. And once you put down something for dv, you will have to integrate it so you can get from dv to v. Imagine, inverse tangent, we're trying to integrate that. If we put that right here, what to integrate it? It's like, that's the original question, right? So we are going to differentiate inverse tangent of x, and then we are just going to be integrating dx. Now, check this out. Right here, to get u, just differentiate both sides. And of course, remember your derivative. The derivative of inverse tangent of x is 1 over 1 plus x squared dx. Technically, it's the differential. And you see that this right here is totally doable. And for this right here, we will have to integrate both sides to get v. And the integral of dx, just think about it as integral of 1 in the x world, we will just get x. And you do not worry about the plus e here, because this is the integral that we are trying to integrate. And then, to get udv, as you can see, it's just this times that, very conveniently. So the first part is going to be this times that, and let me put down the x first. So we have x times inverse tangent of x. And then the second part says we will have to subtract the integral of v du, and v du happens to be right here, isn't it? We have v du, so we are just going to be multiplying these two things together and put that inside of the integral. So we have the x right here, and let me actually just write it like this, x times 1 over 1 plus x squared dx. Cool. And then of course this integral can be done with u substitution. So just go ahead and try that on your own, or you can watch my other video for it, and I'll tell you the answer. For this integral, x over 1 plus x squared, you put u to be 1 plus x squared, work that out, you will get negative 1 half ln 1 plus x squared. And you don't need absolute value, because 1 plus x squared is always positive. So parentheses will do it. So this right here is the answer for that integral. Now, what would you do if you do DI? Let's see. Integral of inverse tangent of x. What does D represent? Something to be differentiated. What does I represent? Something to be integrated. Isn't that what we said earlier? Yes. And now, on the side, to get ready, let's to put down plus, minus. Sometimes you will have more, so make sure you check out my other video for different steps This is the case when we have the second stop. Okay, do I really want to put down this right here under integration? No, right? Same idea. So I'm gonna put this down right here. We will be differentiating in first tangent. Integrating what though? Dx, or we can just put down one and remember that we are in the x world. Hey, isn't this the same as this and that? Yeah, and then differentiate this one time, we get 1 over 1 plus x squared. Integrate this, we get x. It tells you what to do. It's extremely convenient to remind you that what you are supposed to do. And this right here is exactly that. Guess what? How do we get the answer? This times this. And that's exactly u times v. And that's exactly what we got over there. After that, why do we have the minus? Because the formula says so, isn't it? The plus is because originally this integral is positive, just like this integral originally is positive, yeah? But this right here is a negative integral. So you will just have to multiply these two things in this row, this times that, along with the negative, yeah? And then you put that itself an integral. So of course you can see that this times that is this right here, and then minus the integral of the product of this and that. And then again, this right here, just do it with the regular u sub. So this right here is totally the same as integration by parts. It's just an easier way to organize all your work. So finally, this chart will be helpful. It's like this, d and an I plus or minus. To get this formula, you have the u here and then dv here. That's exactly what we did right here. Differentiate this one time, we get du. Integrate this one time, we get v. Have a look, this times this. By the way, when you multiply each row, it's an integral. So it tells you the integral of u dv, positive. Yeah, when you multiply this and that. Okay, you proceed by doing the diagonal. Technically, you plus with the positive, so positive u times v. That will give you uv. Yeah? And then what do we do with this? Well, again, we are going to multiply these two things and then put that itself an integral. But that's a minus. So minus the integral du times v, and we can write it as v du. This is the same as that. And we are